Sincerely, thanks to the British Society of Nanomedicines for selecting and giving me an opportunity to present a part of my work in this beautiful platform. Myself, Mamta Kumawat, and I am from Amiti University, Rajasthan, India. Today, I am presenting a part of my work of PhD entitled as Surface Engineering Strategies for Gold Nanoparticles Towards Enhancing Their Biomedical Potential. The work is under supervised by Hemant Kumar Daima and Professor Nirish Revaprasadu. Before I would like to start with my work, I wanted to put a small light on the whatever the work which we are currently doing in our laboratories. So we are basically working with the multifunctional nanomaterials and their nanocomposite. We are also looking forward for their nanobiome interfaces, their management towards multidrug resistance bacteria, and we are also looking forward for the various applications in the field of nanozyme activity, biosensor, and medicines. So when we talk about this amazing world of nanoscience, we all know that it had started with the famous talk given by Dr. Richard Feynman in 1959 that speaks about there's a plenty of room at the bottom. But however, being a biotechnology, I must say that nature is the first nanotechnology for the creation of these molecules. When we talk about these molecules, they bear the physical principles, chemical properties, and biological characteristics. However, when we synthesize these molecules in the different way applications, we need to look forward for their toxicity that might be induced with the physicochemical properties of these molecules in order to enhance their activity towards better functionality, sensitivity, and specificity. We have so many materials which are available. So here is the list of materials which are available. I'm basically looking forward for the metallic nanoparticle in that to gold nanoparticles. We can synthesize these nanoparticles via two approaches, top-down and the bottom-up approach. In my work, I had used bottom-up approach for the synthesis of gold nanoparticles. I had selected these gold nanoparticles for their important properties and listed here. They are inert in nature, biocompatible, unique. They possess a unique property. We can also improve the surface engineering strategies for the enhancement of their potential application in the field of nanomedicines. So here I would like to start with my work. So my work, the entitled as Surface Engineering Strategies for the Gold Curcumin-based Nanoparticle Using an Antibiotic, Amino Acid, and Antioxidant. So here I enlisted few structures of curcumin, INS, tyrosine, and quercetin. When we talk about the curcumin, we all know that it's a basic ingredient of our kitchen, and it possesses the unique properties like antioxidant, viral, tumor. However, it does have the poor absorption rate, rapid metabolism, and poor solubility. So we thought that we'll take this molecule and put it into the surface of the gold nanoparticle for the enhancement of its properties. We had further surface modified the molecule with the help of the antibiotic called as isoniazid. We had selected these antibiotics because it is basically a first-line drug used for the treatment of the cancer and the mycobacterium tuberculosis infection. But the long-term usage of this drug can lead to the hepatotoxicity, and also it can increase the drug resistance. So if at all we will put this drug onto the surface of the gold nanoparticle coated with the curcumin, we can basically reduce its toxicity. The work has been previously published by our research group into the Colloid and Surfaces Journal, state that these curcumin-coated isoniazid nanoparticles, they can show the selective anti-cancerous action. We had further chosen two more molecules. One is the amino acids and another is an antioxidant molecule. The amino acids been chosen because of its property that we can easily control the surface of the nanoparticle by just varying the pH of the solutions. We had next selected the molecule of quercetin. Quercetin, it possesses the anti-tumor and antioxidant, anti-inflammatory, antiviral, antibacterial. However, it does has the low solubility, the poor viability, and the poor absorption rate. But when we compare these surfaces of the nanoparticles, we can basically contribute to the surface chemistry's involvement into the gold nanoparticle surfaces, and that can further can be used for the betterment of the potential application in the field of biomedicine. So the structure which is just pop up, it shows the interaction of the curcumin nanoparticle with the gold surface, and you can see a fine red color has been seen after formation of with the curcumin. Here we had used curcumin as a reducing agent and the stabilizing agent. Moving forward, for the physical properties of the nanoparticle to confirm their formation and at the same time what kind of charges they possess in their hydrodynamic radii. So on the left-hand side, you can see an optical image has been put. That image shows the wine red color. indicating that the particle has been formed successfully. In the three subsequent qubits, you can see a little bit difference or change in the color. The color has been due to the surface modification of these molecules with an INS, tyrosine, and curacitin. Further, on the downside of that image, I had put an SPR image. That SPR shows the sharp increase in the peak value between 500 to 600, confirming the formation of these nanoparticles. The subsequent functionalization of the molecule can lead to the further shift into the SPR values, confirming their formation. We had further looked forward for their morphological properties, and you can see I had put a stem in images on the right up on the right hand side. So these images show that 90% of the particles they possesses the mono they are monodisperse and they possess a spherical nature, confirming their stability into the colloidal suspension. We had further seen their surface charges and their hydrodynamic radii. The zeta potential values enlisted here, they are in the minus charge starting from minus 20 to minus 20. So these values indicate that particles they bear the negative charge, and the hydrodynamic radii shows that there is an increase in the values. So these all leads to the confirmation of the formation of the nanoparticles. So by moving from here to the next level, it is a determination of the biological properties of these molecules. So the biological properties is been done by various assays. However, due to the time constraint, I had put three assays, and I will just brief about this assay. So we had done the peroxidase activity, the radical scavenging activity, and the cytotoxicity assay by using LDH. The peroxidase activity on the left-hand side graph, it shows that AU nanoparticles with curcumin, it does possess a peroxidase activity. However, when we had surface functionalized the molecule with the help of three moieties, the activity is further enhanced, suggesting that the role of the corona, of surface corona, actually plays a very important role in enhancing the enzyme-like properties. You can see that AU nanoparticles further surface coated with the tyrosine shows the highest activity. In the right hand side, I had put a graph of radical scavenging activity. The radical scavenging activity, basically we had selected a three doses of the nanoparticle, and you can see the activity is the dose dependent activity. The AU nanoparticle curcumin, it does have the scavenging activity of the radical, but when we had surface modified, the activity in case of curacitin molecule, since curcumin and curacitin, they both are polyphenol and they possess the antioxidant nature. So the activity is further increased. So it suggests that the study is basically the plays a role with the surface bearing moieties, and at the same time, with the dose dependent, the activity is further increased. We had further moved and done an assay called as LDH assay. So basically, I will just put a few words about the principle of this assay. So LDH is an enzyme, and it leads to the conversion of the lactate to pyruvate by the reduction of NAD. And it forms an INT formalin product that can be spectrophotometrically can be detected. It basically represents the percentage viable cytotoxicity. But here in my graph, I have basically converted into the percentage viability. So when the cell die, this LDH actually is released out from the cell into the cytoplasm, and then it will lead to the formation of the product. I had basically selected five different doses and done the dose-dependent activity. The data represent here, it shows the percentage viability of the molecule onto the mouse macrophages cells. So you can see that till 4.90 microgram per ml, none of the particles showed the toxic effect to the cell, confirming that the surface corona played an important role. However, in few, like in INS part, you will see a little bit of reduction in the toxicity, but the toxicity is not significant to look or to, you know, to confirm it. When you see the AU nanoparticle curcumin with the curiosity, it basically shows the additional advantage onto the viability, confirming that these molecules can be used further for the two different assays, and then these nanoparticles doesn't have any lethal effect onto the cells. However, it has the positive effect onto the cells that can be used further for the biomedical applications. We had also done the RBC activity on the RBC activity on by taking the human red blood cells, and we also found that there is not much, and there is not a bursting of the RBC that can be taken place by using these AU nanoparticles surface coated with the curcumin, INS, tyrosine, and quercetin. But since the time doesn't allow me to put the results over here, so now I would like to conclude my work that we had successfully formed the gold nanoparticle by using curcumin as a reducing agent, and then we had subsequently surface functionalized them with an antibiotic, an amino acid, and antioxidant. The surface modification of the molecule with the curcumin leads to the increase in the activity when we had modified with the tyrosine, the peroxidase activity is increased. The further we can say that the radical scavenging activity of AU nanoparticle curcumin with the quercetin does show a higher activity. However, in the past, our group also published a similar kind of work, but they had used, when we talk about, but they had used these INH, curcumin, and quercetin molecule as a reducing agent. In my case, I had used them as a functionalizing agent to enhance their activity further. So here I can conclude that we can say that the comparison between the biological activity between an antibiotic and amino acid and antioxidant on the surface of gold nanoparticle could provide a better understanding towards the surface chemistries of the gold nanoparticle involvement, and also these particles can find a better future or better application toward the therapeutic field. I would like to acknowledge these members who were involved with me throughout my work. I would like to thank my parental university, Amity University, Rajasthan, my supervisor, Dr. Hemant Kumar Dayama, my co-supervisor, Professor Nilesh Deva Prasadu, Dr. Harish Kumar Mazdetta from University of Miyazaki, Dr. Mandeep Singh from RMIT University. And thank you so much for the platform for giving me an opportunity to present a little bit of my work. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mamta. Brilliant talk. Very exciting work. I'm a particular advocate of gold nanoparticles, so I was particularly interested in your slide. I do have a few questions, but I think I will focus on those that have come from the audience. So you have actually generated quite a bit of interest. Let me just kind of scroll up and see. Okay, so this is our first question. So you have showed that particle size with curcumin, tyrosine is in a range of size for each. Do you feel that the wide range of nanoparticle size for each drug may have some role on drug loading?
Yes, ma'am. They does have the role in the playing, but if at all we'll increase the size, then they might switch the aggregation, and you know, we doesn't lead to the stop into the their application part. So yes, we need to be look forward for their size.
Okay. Another question from Dr. Neil Liptrot. Hi, Mamta. Great talk and really interesting work. Can you tell me what controls you included in your LDH assay? Gold nanoparticles are well known to interact with such assays, for example, the MTT. There is also conversion of the reagent on the gold nanoparticle that gives an overestimation of viability.
Yes, ma'am, we does taken the control, but since the time doesn't allow me to put these controls over here, so basically I just put my result data over, but we does took the control in the form of the pristine molecules, like pristine curcumin we took, pristine INH, and tyrosine and quercetin molecule. But we can say that after formation of the nanoparticle, we had able to reduce the toxicity to the further extent.
Okay, lovely. Thank you. There's another comment. Thank you for the talk, Mamta. The radical scavenging data you shared appears to be based on large quantities of gold nanoparticles and very different millimolar versus microgram. From the doses you use for your viability, can cells tolerate the high scavenging doses?
Yes, we had in the past, we had published like whatever the doses I had used. So below 300 and above 700, we had still published the data in the past, and based on those studies only, we had decided these kind of doses to take forward for the antioxidant activity. And we can clearly see that these particles, they are actually cleansing the radicals.
That's lovely, Mamta. Thank you so much.